Already in the previous video, we have seen the basic concepts of the page. Now we will see some more details about the paging in memory management. The operating system maintains a frame table, which contains the details like which frame is free or allocated, if allocated, to which page of which process, etc. For example, here this already we know that user process, let us take this as a user process that is divided into pages. So this particular user's process requires 1, 2, 3, 4 pages. The page size starts from 0 to 3, so it is 4 pages here. And we call the user process as page, and when it is allocated in the main memory we call it as a frame. And we have already seen that page size and frame size should be same. If the page size is 512 bytes, the frame size also must be 512 bytes. This is the rule. So then only each page can be exactly allocated one frame. So for example, page 0 can be placed here, page 1 can be placed in this page frame, and so on. So you know the terminology, for the user process is divided into pages, and the same amount of space is divided in the main memory, and we call that as a frame. So both page size and frame size should be equal, then only the allocation is possible. So this is the strict rule of paging. Now say for example, if a new user process arrives, here there are say 4 pages. There must be 4 free available frames in the main memory. One more strict rule in paging is the whole of the user process must be available in the main memory for it to be executed. In contiguous memory allocation, what we have seen is the pages, the user process should be in continuous memory. So for example, if the user process here say some 512 bytes means all the 512 bytes must be in contiguous memory. You cannot allocate some 100 bytes here, then another 100 bytes here, another 100 bytes here, and so on. It's not possible. So there must be a continuous space for allocation. That is what the drawback in the continuous allocation. Not only that, the whole of the user process must be there. Here, one thing is eliminated. One disadvantage is eliminated. That is, here there is no need for the user process to be in a continuous memory allocation. That is because of this paging. Because here, since we are dividing the user the main memory into frames, the operating system will keep track of how many frames are free and how many frames are allocated for other users. Okay, and for which process they are all. Like suppose there are some 5 processes is occupying the main memory, means which frames those processes are occupying and what are all the remaining frames free. All those things informations will be kept by the operating system with the help of a frame table. So the operating system maintains a frame table which contains the details like which frame is free and which frame is allocated. If allocated, to which page that particular process, that particular frame has been allocated, and so on. The restriction here is the whole of the user process must be in the main memory. Only thing is they can be anywhere in the main memory. There is no need for the continuous allocation. But anyway, it must be present in the main memory. That restriction is still there. So to run a program of size n pages, need n free frames in order to load it, in order to run the program. So if there are 4 pages, 4 free frames must be available. Then only this process can enter into the main memory. Suppose this has 4 pages, but there are only 3 frames are available. Then this process has to wait till the required amount of frame is available for it. So if n frames are available, they are allocated to the arriving process. The first page of the process is loaded into one of the allocated frames, and the frame number is put in the page table of this process. So for example, these are all the free frame list. So 13 is free, 14 is free, 15 is free, 18 is free, and 20 is free. The one with this color is free, and this is understand to be occupied. So it gives a free frame list. These are all the free frame lists. So the page zero, when the new process arrives, it will be divided into pages, and the first page will be loaded in the first free frame available, that is the 14. So in 14, if you see that in 14 page zero, after assigning in that, now this becomes occupied, and this entry is made in the page table of this process. So this page table, the page table of this process will consist of four entries. So the zeroth page is allocated. So after it is allocated the free frame, allotted frame, that frame number will be entered in the page table. So zeroth frame is zeroth page is present in 14th frame. And then the next process, page one, is allocated. Next page one is allocated in the next free frame, that is 13. So after it is placed there, this frame number is entered in the page table, and so on. So 2 is placed in the next free frame, which is nothing but 18, and page 3 is put in 15, and then it is sorry 20, and the page table is updated. Here there is no external fragmentation. That is one advantage, but internal fragmentation still exists. Say for example, this if the page size is, let us consider a page size of 2048 bytes. A process requires 72,766 bytes. Let us imagine a process needs this much of bytes, and the page size is 2048. So when I say 2048 is the page size, the frame size also must be of the same size. Okay, so this when you divide this by this page size, it needs 35 pages. Yes or no? So 35 pages needed for loading this plus 1086. So after you allocate, say for example, 35 into 2048, it needs 71,680. And then when you subtract this from the page, you get 1080. So totally 36 pages are needed. 35 pages are fully occupied, and the remaining bytes of this process needs one more page for allocation. And the remaining byte is nothing but 1086. So it would be allocated 36 frames, resulting in an internal fragmentation of what is the page size? 2048 or frame size. So 2048 and the remaining byte 1080. When you subtract this, you get 962. So the 962 bytes are wasted. That page will occupy only 1086, and the remaining space is 962 bytes. So this 962 bytes is unoccupied, but it has to be allocated, because the whole, if you allocate for the whole space only, that process can be executed. You can't leave this. So for that, you have to allocate one extra page. In the worst case, a process would need n pages plus one byte. Sometimes only for one byte, say for example 72766 means 72765 pages will be it will be allocated on them, but there will be one byte remaining of the process. For that, you have to allocate one more frame. So that is what here said. So in the worst case, a process would need n pages plus one byte. It would be allocated n plus 1 frames, resulting in an internal fragmentation of almost an entire frame. So if a process size is independent of the page size, expected internal fragmentation will be average one half page. So you can expect in an average, the half of the page will be wasted for each process. So this consideration lead us how we can eliminate this problem. So one thing is, you can consider the page size to be small, so that the reduction of spaces, the unused space will be less. But this leads to another problem. What is it? So for example, in the previous, let us take in the previous example itself. The previous what we have taken is the page size, we have taken a 2048. Let us consider to be the page size small. 512 bytes. Okay, the page size 512, so the frame size also will be 512. And same, the process takes 7276. So when you divide this by 512 bytes, you will get the number of pages, which is nothing but 142 plus one more page, that is 143, because 142 pages plus 62 bytes. See this calculation, 142 into 512 will lead to 72704. So when you subtract this, this is the actual size of the process and this is the page sizes. Then when you subtract, there is remaining 62 bytes are left of this process. For that, we have to allocate one more frame. So it will be allocated 143 frames, resulting in an internal fragmentation of 500, because 512 is the frame size. So 512 minus the remaining 62 is 450 bytes. So if you see that here 962 bytes are wasted, whereas here 450 bytes only wasted. If you reduce the page size still, the space wasted may be less, but this leads to another problem where the number of entry, if you say here only four page, let us say four pages are needed, or here if you say that 36, only 36 entries in the page table, but here 143 entries for the same program, same process, if the page size is reduced, then 143 entries has to be made for a page table. So what happens, this leads to lot of, this increases the number of entries in the page table, and because of that what happens, many pages has to be transferred from the secondary storage to the main memory. This overhead, generally page size, also disk IO is more efficient when the number of data being transferred is larger. So what happens, because of this page entry is more, number of pages to be transferred is also more, but this leads to lot of context switches. So in order to reduce, if the page size is more, even if we neglect the small, the space which the internal fragmentation is created, then we can improve the performance of the operating system, because if the page size is more, the more number of that is more space, the process size will be more, that can be at a time, it can be transferred to the main memory. So this overhead can be reduced if the size of the page is increased. That is what, if you increase the page size, the disk IO is more efficient when the number of data being transferred is larger. Here we transfer the data with this type of page by page from the secondary storage to main memory. So at a time, 2048 pages will be transferred to this main memory, whereas here only 512. So there will be lot of transfer of data, whereas here the bulk data is transferred at a time. So this increase the disk IO. So generally page sizes have grown over time as processes, data sets and main memory have become larger. Nowadays the page size has been increased more. So now here to today, pages typically are between 4 KB and 8 KB in size, and some systems supports even large page sizes. So some CPUs and kernels even support multiple page sizes. See, not only 512, sometimes it may be 2000, more than that, like that. For instance, Solaris uses page size of 8 KB and 4 MB, depending on the data stored. So depending on the data, the page size may vary and frame size may vary. The operating system maintains a copy of the page table for each process, just as it maintains a copy of the instruction counter and register content. So the OS keeps a copy of the page table of each process. Why it needs? Because whenever the particular process is transferred, it will be easy for it to fill up the page, take it from the page table and push the data into the respective frames. This copy is used to translate, and this page table is the one which helps in transferring the logical address to the physical address. Okay. So this copy is used to translate logical address to physical address whenever the operating system must map a logical address to a physical address memory. That is what we have seen. In user process, That is how we have seen the user process divided into pages, and it will be placed in the frames. For that, where it is placed is kept in the page table. So this is the user memory and user page. This will be in physically where it is present is here. So using this, the operating system translates the logical address into physical address. So it is also used by the CPU dispatcher to define the hardware page table when a process is to be allocated the CPU. So, but anyway, this paging increases the context switch time.